ಸೆಟ್ಲರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಬೆಂಚ್ ಕೊಂತ ದೀನ್ ಇಂದ ವೀಗಿನ ಇಂದ ವೀಗಿದೆ ಯಾಡ ಬಬಲ್ಸ್ ಹೊತ್ತಾಯ ಮೂರು ಬೆಟ್ಟದ ರೆಂಡು ಬೆಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿದೆ ಎಟ್ಲ ಸೆಟ್ಲರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಬೆಂಚ್ ಕೊಂತೆ ಹಂಡ್ರೆಡ್ ಬೆಟ್ಕೊಂತೆ ಇದು ಬೆಂಚ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ಎಕ್ಕೋ
ಹಂಡ್ರೆಡ್ చూద్దాం పవన్ తో లింక్ అని తీసుకోబో పవన్ తో లింక్ ఉన్నది
ఏది తీసుకోవాలా అదే చూపిస్తా నింగ ఇది చూపిల తిప్పి తిప్పి ఒక నిమిషం లేట్ కదా హలో
ఒరిజినల్ వాయిస్
నువ్వు మాట్లాడారు
ఆయన ఫోన్ చేసి ఆఫ్ చేయమని కూర్చోము కాదు అది మాట్లాడదారు కానీ పెట్టుకోవచ్చా లైవ్ స్ట్రీమ్లో
లైవ్
పిలుచు ఆయన చెప్పు పవన్కి హాఫ్ చేసిన ఇప్పుడు వాయిస్ కట్ చేయమన్న వాళ్ళు వచ్చి మాట్లాడదారు చేయమన్న ఇప్పుడు మనం ఏం మాట్లాడాలి అయిపోతుంది అవడం జస్ట్ మ్యూట్ కొడితే చాలా దాని ఏం పెద్ద సెట్టింగ్ చేంజ్ లేదు ఇప్పుడు ఆఫ్ చేయమన్న
ఆఫ్ చేసాం
ఆయన వచ్చి మాట్లాడితే కూడా ఆయన పైగా ఓపెన్ సౌండ్ వస్తుంది ఆవిడ ఆన్
చేస్తాను
ఇప్పుడు ఆఫ్ చేయమన్న
కొంచెం ముందుకు వేసుకోవచ్చు ఎవరిని వచ్చేవాళ్ళు ఆర్డర్ చేసుకోవాలి
లింక్ పంపి
జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ స్మారక వరతేజమా సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే మేజర్ మ్యార్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దినదినము వర్ధిల్లి అఖిలాంధ్ర దేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి అభ్యుదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలిరారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలూరు రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు లేపాక్షికల అనంత జిల్లాల పే జయ అనంత జయంతియు నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే 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 విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ స్మారక వరతేజమా సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే మేజర్ మ్యార్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దినదినము వర్ధిల్లి అఖిలాంధ్ర దేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి అభ్యుదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు లేపాక్షికల అనంత జిల్లాల పెన్నిధి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ స్మారక వర తేజమా సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే జర్మర్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దినదినము వర్ధిల్లి అఖిలాంధ్ర దేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి హృదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు ఏ పాక్షికల కనంత జిల్లాల పెన్నిధి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు జయ అనంత జయంతియు జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ స్మారక వర తేజమా సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే మేజర్ మ్యార్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దినదినము వర్ధిల్లి అఖిలాంధ్ర దేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి హృదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు లేపాక్షికల అనంత జిల్లాల పెన్నిధి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు జయ అనంత జయంతియు జయ జయ హే. జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా. జవహరులాల్ నెహ్రూ స్మారక వర తేజమా. సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా. భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా. జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతి. స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే మేజర్ మ్యార్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దినదినము వర్ధిల్లి. అఖిలాంధ్ర దేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి. అభ్యుదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి. మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి. జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతి. శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు. ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు. శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు. ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు. విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప. రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు. రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు. లేపాక్షి కళక అనంత జిల్లాల పెన్నిధి. జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతి. నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన. అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన. క్రీస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జవహరులాల్ నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా జవహరులాల్ నెహ్రూ స్మారక వర తేజమా సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే మేజర్ మ్యార్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దినదినము వర్ధిల్లి అఖిలాంధ్ర దేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి హృదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు లేపాక్షి కడక అనంత జిల్లాల పెన్నిధి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు జయ జయ హే నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా జవహరులాలు నెహ్రూ స్మారక వర తేజమా సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే మేజర్ మ్యార్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దినదినము వర్ధిల్లి అఖిలాంధ్రదేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి అద్భుతయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి మేధావులనందించే మేలిని విద్యల తల్లి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు శేషాచల గిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు ಲಸಿಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರಂ ಶ್ರೀಹರಿ ಕೋಟಗಲ ನೆಲ್ಲೂರು ಲೇಪಾಕ್ಷಿಗಳ ಕಣಂತ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾಲ ತಿನ್ನಿಧಿ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಅನಂತ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ನವೋನ್ಮೇಷ ಮೌಬೋಧನ ಯುವತ ಭವಿತ ಕಾಲಂಬನ ನಿಸ್ತುಲ ಕ್ರೀಡಲ ಸಾಧನ ನೀತಿ ಸೂತ್ರ ಮೂಲ ಪ್ರೇರಣ ನಿರ್ಮಲ ಸೇವಾಚರಣ ನಿರುಪಮಾನಮೈ ಜಗಾನ ವಿಜೇತನನು ಸೃಷ್ಟಿಸಿ ವಿಶಿಷ್ಟತನು ಚಾಟು ಜನನಿ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ದೇಶ ಪ್ರಗತಿ ದಿವ್ಯ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಪ್ರದಾಯಿನಿ ಜವಾಹರಲಾಲ್ ನೆಹರೂ ಸಾಂಕೇತಿಕ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ವಿಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾಲಯ ವಾಣಿ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಅನಂತ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಜಯ ಅನಂತ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಅನಂತ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನ ಕಾಂತಿ ಪುಂಜಮ ಜವಾಹರಲಾಲ್ ನೆಹರೂ ಸ್ಮಾರಕ ವರ ತೇಜಮ ಸಾಂಕೇತಿಕ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಕಲ್ಪ ಭೂಜಮ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಅನಂತ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯಾನಿಕಿ ಪೂರ್ವಮೇ ಮೇಂದೇ ಆದಿಯೈ ವಿಲಸಿಲ್ಲಿ ಅಭ್ಯುದಯ ವಿಕಾಸ ಶ್ರೀ ವಿಶ್ವಮೆಲ್ಲ ವಿಸ್ತರಿಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇಧಾವುಲ ನಂದಿಂಚೆ ಮೇಲಿನಿ ವಿದ್ಯಲ ತಲ್ಲಿ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಶೇಷಾಚಲ ಗಿರುಲ ಸಿರುಲ ಚೆಲುವಾರು ಚಿತ್ತೂರು ಆ ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు, రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు, విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప, రోదశి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోటది ఎన్టీయు. నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన, అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన, నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన, నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ, నిర్మల సేవాచరణ, నిరుపమానమై జగాన, విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని, జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే, దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని, జవహరులాల్ నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి, జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే, జయ అనంత జయంతియు. జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే, విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా, జవహరులాల్ నెహ్రూ స్మారక వర తేజమా, సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా, భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా, జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే, జయ అనంత జయంతియు. స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే మేజర్ మ్యార్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దిన దినము వర్ధిల్లి, అఖిలాంధ్రదేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి, హృదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి, మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి, జయ జయ హే, జయ జయ హే, జయ అనంత జయంతియు. శేషాచలగిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు శేషాచలగిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరి కోట గల నెల్లూరు రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరి కోట గల నెల్లూరు పాక్షికల అనంత జిల్లాల పెన్నిధి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జేఎన్టీయు నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జవహరులాల్ నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జేఎన్టీయు జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే విజ్ఞాన కాంతి పుంజమా జవహరులాల్ నెహ్రూ స్మారక వర తేజమా సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ రాజమా భవ్య సీమలో వెలసిన అక్షర కల్ప భూజమా జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జేఎన్టీయు స్వాతంత్ర్యానికి పూర్వమే మేజర్ మ్యార్లీ స్థాపించిన కళాశాల దినదినము వర్ధిల్లి అఖిలాంధ్ర దేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి
అఖిలాంధ్ర దేశమందే ఆది అయి విలసిల్లి
హృదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు శేషాచలగిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు శేషాచలగిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు లేపాక్షికల కనంత జిల్లాల పెన్నిధి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జ విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే హృదయ వికాస శ్రీ విశ్వమెల్ల విస్తరిల్లి మేధావులనందించే మేలిమి విద్యల తల్లి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు శేషాచలగిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు శేషాచలగిరుల సిరుల చెలువారు చిత్తూరు ఆంధ్రుల తొలి రాజధాని నగరమైన కర్నూలు విలువైన ఖనిజాల నెలవైన కడప గడప రోదసి కేంద్రం శ్రీహరికోట గల నెల్లూరు జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే జయ అనంత జయంతియు నవోన్మేషమౌబోధన యువత భవిత కాలంబన అధునాతన పరిశోధనల ఆవిష్కరణల కల్పన నిస్తుల క్రీడల సాధన నీతి సూత్రముల ప్రేరణ నిర్మల సేవాచరణ నిరుపమానమై జగాన విజేతలను సృష్టించి విశిష్టతను చాటు జనని జయ జయ హే జయ జయ హే దేశ ప్రగతి దివ్య శక్తి ప్రదాయిని జవహరులాల్ నెహ్రూ సాంకేతిక శాస్త్ర విశ్వవిద్యాలయ వాణి జయ జయ హే జయ జయ
మహాన్ దేవత మహాలక్ష్మి మహా సరస్వతి ఆవాస దేవత నమస్త రాజోపచారీ మహా సరస్వతి మహామాయాయన కామరూపాయ మహా మహావిద్యాయ మహా మహాపాదక వినాశిని మహా మహాసేన మహా మాలినీయ మహా మహాభోగాయ మహా మహాభయన మహా మహోత్సాయన మహా దివ్యాంగన మహా సురవందితాయన మహా మహాకాళ్యాయన మహా మహాపాచన మహా మహాకారాయన మహా మహాంకుషాయన మహా సీతాయన మహా విమలాయన మహా విశ్వాయన మహా విద్యున్మాలాయన మహా వైష్ణవీయన మహా చంద్రకాయన మహా చంద్రలేఖ భూస్తాయన మహా సావిత్రి మహా గురుదైన మహా దేవి అయిన మహా దివ్యాలంకార భూస్తాయన మహా వాక్యవీన మహా వారాశ్రయ మహా వారజాసాయన మహా చిత్రాంబరాయన మహా చిత్రగంధాయన మహా చిత్రమాలిక భూస్తాయన మహా కాంతాయన మహా సంజాయన మహా బ్రహ్మ విష్ణు వాత్మన మహా త్రికాల గ్రహం శ్రీ మహాసరస్వతి మహా నానావిధ రవ్య బ్రహ్మల పత్రభూషణోపయామి రూపమాత్రాపయామి మంగళం దీపం త్రైలోక్యం దిమిరావ భక్త్యాధిపురేచ్ఛామి దేవాయ పరమాత్మే రాహిమం నరకాత్ ఘోరాదికం నమో ఆవాదేభ్యో సర్వేభ్యో దేవతాభ్యో నమః రక్షాంధారయామి నమస్కరోమి జై జగదాంబ విశ్వభవాని మాతాకు జై సరస్వతి మాతాకు జై దుర్గా మాతాకు జై లక్ష్మీ రమణ గోవింద హరి గోవింద
ప్రకారం
జయంతికి సీతయ్య సార్ ఏమనుకుంటు తమ్ముడు ఖర్చు అవుతుంది మీ ఇష్టం అండి ఖర్చు అవుతుంది ఎండకి అదే సార్ ఇప్పుడు సంపదాలు ఇప్పటికే ఎట్లా కండి రాము ఇయ్యప్ప మాది
మాస్క్ వస్తుంది లేకపోతే కరోనా వస్తుంది అందరూ పెట్టుకుంటారు నువ్వు కూడా పెట్టుకో మేము పెట్టుకోలే కదా
అట్లీస్ట్ మీ దగ్గర నుంచి నాకు రాదు నా దగ్గర నుంచి మీకు రాదు
అందుకు
మనం అంతా ఇక్కడే ఉన్నాం
స్వామి
ఇక్కడ నుంచే తీసుకోండి
వాళ్ళు సైడ్ పోతారు అటు నుంచి ఇక్కడ ఉంటే మనం గాడి పోతారు
సంజయ్
సార్ దాన్ని పైన తీసుకెళ్ళు, దాన్ని కింద పెడతా.
ఎట్లా అంటే సార్
సైడ్
సైడ్
సైడ్ సార్
కమ్ముకోకండి సార్
సార్ సార్ మీరు కొద్దిగా వెనక్కి సార్
కొద్దిగా సార్ సార్
వెనక్కి సార్
అది నిలబెట్టి ఎనికి పోతాం
సార్
సార్ సార్ కొంచెం వెనక్కి పోండి సార్ మీరు కొంచెం వెనక్కి పోండి
సార్ బాగుంది బాగుంది సార్ సాయి సార్ సాయి సార్ పెడదాం ఇవ్వకరా సార్ ముందర
సార్ మేడం మేడం కొంచెం సైడ్ మేడం సార్ కొంచెం సైడ్ సార్ మేడం
సార్ సార్
ఒకసారి మా బ్యాచ్ మేట్స్ అందరినీ కూడా తీసుకుంటాం బయట ఫ్రెండ్స్ అంతా వచ్చిన్నారు
బాబు ఒక నిమిషం
బాబు
బాబు
సార్ 884 అల్యూమిని
అన్న మీరు ఎన్ని గ్రాండ్ అన్నా
పక్క జరగప్ప చెప్తా
ఉంటాను
ఒక నిమిషం ఆగండి
సార్ మొబైల్
సార్ ఫోన్ ఆపి
కాదు సెల్ఫీ
సార్
సార్ కొంచెం ఇచ్చారు సార్, మీరు లాస్ట్ లాస్ట్ కొంచెం జరగండి సార్, మీరు
కొంచెం
ఫ్రీ సార్
చంద్రమౌళి చంద్రమౌళి గారు సార్ చంద్రమౌళి గారు సార్ ప్లీజ్ కమ్ సార్ చంద్రమౌళి గారు చౌదరి సార్ చంద్రమౌళి గారు వచ్చారా ఆ విక్టోరియా మేడం ప్లీజ్ రండి మేడం రండి మేడం చంద్రమౌళి గారు అంట చంద్రమౌళి గారు ప్లీజ్ రండి సార్
చంద్రమౌళి ప్లీజ్
సార్ చంద్రమౌళి గారు చంద్రమౌళి గారు
సార్
గ్రూప్ ఫోటోలు అయిపోయాయి
సైడ్ వన్ ఫోటోగ్రాఫర్
మీరు జస్ట్
మేడం ఇలా ఇలా తిరగండి కొంచెం సార్ మేడం కొంచెం 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 డౌన్ చేయండి కొంచెం డౌన్ డౌన్ డౌన్
హలో
గోల్డెన్ బౌండరీ
హలో హలో హలో
హలో హ్యాండ్ కొంచెం డౌన్ చేయండి
ఇది కొంచెం మొబైల్ సమయం అయ్యప్ప కొంచెం మొబైల్
మన
అవసరం
కంగ్రాచులేషన్
బండి తీసుకొని
సైన్ సార్ సైడ్ సార్ సార్ నేను కొన్ని పెట్ట
the scientists armed forces personnel my heartiest congratulations on this very important mission a great mission for the country all the observations what we had in the last mission have been analyzed corrected
నా సైడ్ రా సమి
క్లోజ్
వెళ్ళిపోదాం ఓపెన్ చేసిన
ఓపెన్
స్టాండ్ కేసుకుందాం ఇంకా ఇక్కడ ఇక్కడ ఇదా అండి బల్బ్ గుడ్
బల్బ్ బాగుంది
మన ప్లగ్ కాదు మార్చాలి
We request everyone to kindly settle down. Good morning, my lord. We have here a galaxy of intellectuals, MS academicians, pioneering entrepreneurs, great visionaries, and young budding engineers who are all the alumni of JPA College of Engineering.
Standing aloft on a solid foundation of 25 years of glory and rich heritage, these outstanding institutions, our alma mater, has produced many illustrious and distinguished alumni who have excelled in their professional careers as well as entrepreneurs. This rock-solid building stands here as a testimony for 75 years of academic excellence and also as a beacon for technical education in the country.
We are greatly honored today by the presence of Dr. G. Satish Reddy Garu, Secretary to the Department of Defense Research and Development and Chairman of DIO, who happens to be one of the great alumni of JPA College of Engineering, who is an inspiration not only to the thousands of students who are gathered here, but also to millions of students who wish to be the engineers of tomorrow and who wish to contribute towards the progress of our proud nation.
Now we request Professor V. Sulata ma'am and Professor C. Shobha Bindu ma'am to welcome the guests.
We take this opportunity to invite the dignitaries onto the dais. I humbly invite Vice Principal of the College, Dr. V. Dilgam Sargar, onto the dais. So request students to welcome him.
Students to welcome her. We invite Registrar of the University, Professor Shri Shashidhar Garu, onto the dais. Welcome, sir. We invite Rector of the University, Professor M. Vijay Kumar Garu, onto the dais. Welcome, sir. We invite our beloved Vice Chancellor, Professor G. Rangajanathan Garu, to grace the dais.
We take the pleasure of inviting the guest of honor of today's event, Professor K. Hemachandra Reddy, Chairman APSHI, onto the dais. It's an honor for us to invite the chief guest of today's event, Professor Dr. Satish Reddy Garu, Chairman DRDO, onto the dais. We request Sri Narayan Reddy Garu, EMC and Technical Advisor to CM, onto the dais.
We take the pleasure of inviting distinguished guests who have graced the occasion today. We invite Professor S.A. Kohli Garu, Vice Chancellor of Central University of Andhra Pradesh, onto the dais, please. We invite Professor Ramakrishna Reddy Garu, Vice Chancellor, S.K. University, Anantapur, onto the dais, please. We invite Professor A. Anandrav Garu, Vice Chancellor, Rayalaseema University, onto the dais, please.
Now we take the privilege of inviting Aluri Sambasivareddy Garu onto the dais. We request Janalagadda Padmavati, MLA, onto the dais.
We humbly invite our retired faculty who have rendered their services to this prestigious institution. We invite Professor Sai Baba Reddy Garu onto the dais, please. We invite Professor J. Krishnamachari Garu onto the dais, please. We humbly invite Professor Srinivas Shetty Saru onto the dais, please. We invite Professor Pandurangar sir onto the dais, please.
We request Professor V. Shankar sir onto the dais.
Welcome, sir.
We'll start the program with a prayer by our students.
Thank you.
महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि वसिष्ठवामदेवादिवन्दितमहागणपतिं महादेवसुतं महादेवसुतं गुरुकुलनुतं महादेवसुतं गुरुकुलनुतं मारकोटिप्रकाशं शान्तं महाकाव्यनाटकादिप्रियम् महाकाव्यनाटकादिप्रियं मूषिकवाहनमोदकप्रियं महाकाव्यनाटकादिप्रियं मूषिकवाहनमोदकप्रियं महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि वसिष्ठवामदेवादिवन्दितमहागणपतिम्
I request the dignitaries on the dais to light the lamp to start the proceeding of today's meeting.
We request everyone to stand in silence for 2 minutes as a mark of tribute and homage to departed faculty and alumni. Thank you.
Now, I request the First Lady Principal in the history of JNTU College of Engineering to present a report.
So, good morning, one and all. Dignitaries on the dais and off the dais. Today's chief guest, Honorable Secretary of Department of Defense R&D and Chairman DRDO, Dr. Satish Reddy Garu. Today's guest of honor of the function, Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu. Honorable Vice Chancellor Rangajanardhan Reddy Garu, Vice Chancellor Rangajanardhan Garu, Rector of the University, Vijay Kumar Sir, Registrar of the University, Shashidhar Sir, all alumni who are present here, dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, each and every one, distinguished alumni, directors of the university, faculty members, non-teaching staff, students, press and media, a warm welcome to you all for 75 years celebrations of College of Engineering, Anantapur. A brief report of the college. At the time when there was only one government engineering college at Guindy Madras for the entire former composite Madras province, three new government engineering colleges were sanctioned under post-Second World War reconstruction program, one at Coimbatore in 1945, one at Kakinada in 1946, and one at Anantapur in 1946. The College of Engineering Anantapur was temporarily located at Guindy in 1946. And later shifted to Anantapur in 1948. The first batch of 60 students was admitted into the college at Guindy, Madras on 10th June 1946, and so the college started its history journey on that day. Major V.H. Murali was appointed as first full-fledged principal of the college after shifting the college to Anantapur. The college were located in Military Meat Dehydration Factory in the present old campus. All those engineers who went through the kerosene era, who studied in the light of hurricane lamps, rose to very high positions in their professional career all across the globe. The college was formally inaugurated at Anantapur by the then Honorable Chief Minister O. Ramaswamy Reddyar. Later, about 300 acres of land was acquired to establish a new campus. The college main building, 3 laboratories, 1 workshop block, and 1 powerhouse were constructed in the year 1958 at the total cost of 18 lakhs. The college was initially affiliated to Madras University during 1946 to 1955 and Sri Venkateshwara University Tirupati during 1955 to 1972. In the year 1972, under a broad policy of framework of providing technological education required for the industrial growth of the country in general and more particularly for the state of Andhra Pradesh, Jawaharlal Nehru Technological University was established on 2nd October 1972 by an act of state legislature rightly named after the ardent lover of science and technology, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India. Government Engineering College Anantapur, Government Engineering College Kakinada, Government Engineering College Nagarjuna Sagar, later it was shifted to Hyderabad, were made as constituent units. J&T University started functioning from Hyderabad from there. Thus, the College of Engineering Anantapur went into the fold of JNTU and the college was renamed as JNTU College of Engineering Anantapur. Subsequently, JNTU Act 1972 was amended by JNTU Ordinance 1919 to affiliate it to any other college or institution notified by State Government of Andhra Pradesh. Eventually, JNTU Hyderabad has become a multi-campus university. Later in the year 2008, JNTU Hyderabad was divided into 4 independent universities. The Jawaharlal Nehru Technological University Anantapur was established on 18th August 2008 by an act of legislature of state of Andhra Pradesh. JNTUA started functioning in the premises of JNTU College of Engineering Anantapur, formerly the College of Engineering Anantapur. JNTU College of Engineering Anantapur became a constituent college of JNTUA and was renamed as JNTUA College of Engineering Anantapur. At present, JNTUA College of Engineering Anantapur offering 6 UG programs and 22 PG programs. Up to now, College of Engineering Anantapur produced approximately more than thousands of engineering graduates. College produced great alumni throughout the world. Some of the notable alumni are, these are very few, but many more are there. The time is short, so I'll mention a few. Dr. G. Satish Reddy Garu, Secretary of Department of Defense and R&D and Chairman of DRDO. He is today our chief guest. Thank you, sir. Professor K. Balavira Reddy Garu, former VCVTU, former Director, NIT Suratkal. Professor Y. Venkatram Reddy Garu, former VCJNTU, former Chairman, APPSC and former member, UPSC. Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu, Chairman, APSI. Professor G. Rangajanardhan Garu, VC JNTUA. Ramachandra Naidu Garu, Amar Raja Batteries. Haranada Rao Garu, CMD, APSP DCL. Now he is here with us. Ramakant Desai Garu, ex-Vice President, Wipro. He is also now with us. Rama Akirazu, Forbes top 20 women in AI research. She is my classmate, 89-93 batch. A. Giridhar, IAS, Ministry of Road Transports and Highways, Government of India. C. Veeresh, IRPS, Guntakal Railways Division, a very fresh batch. Presently, 28 number of CEA faculty are alumni of this institution. All are here only in this auditorium. Accreditations and recognitions. Accredited by NBA in 2005, 2013, 2016, and 2019. NIRF ranking with a band of 185 in 2020. Secured UGC autonomy status in 2014. Certified by ISO. And here many constructions are there. Classroom complex, new block for CSE, a gym and tennis court. They are ready to occupy. Indoor sports complex and hostel room under construction. Gold medals for the students. University gold medals for all the six branches. ANECA 1982 endowment gold medals for best performed boy and girl. 11 number of endowment gold medals for various BTech disciplines. 3 number of endowment gold medals for various MTech disciplines. MOUs with our university are EduNet Foundation, Wellfinity Healthcare, Southern Region Farm Machinery Training and Testing Institute, Smart Bridge Technologies, Renewable Energy Development Corporation of IP, APSSDC, Eftronic Systems, NPTI, and so many are there. These are very few. Received grants from TechWIP 1 and TechWIP 3. And faculty of College of Engineering Anantapur received approximately 6 crores of funding from various agencies like AICTE, UGC, VRNS, DST, etc. in the last 10 years. NSS, NCC program, sir, Professor MLS Devakumar, Faculty of Mechanical Engineering received prestigious Indira Gandhi National Service Scheme IGNSS Award on behalf of JNTUA from the Honorable President of India, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, in Rashtrapati Bhavan, New Delhi on 19th November 2016. N. Naveen Kumar, MTech in DECS, received NSS Award for the year 2018-19 in the category of volunteer from Honorable President of India, Ramnath Koidzi. NSS units of CEE organized more than 115 programs in post 10 years, which include blood donation camps, health camps, Swachh Bharat programs, village adoptions, etc. College of Engineering Anantapur have more than NCC cadets, and many of them participated in various national level camps. Our research area is many of our faculty visited abroad to attend various conferences. Dr. Jarina, Assistant Professor of Physics, was awarded Raman Postdoctoral Fellowship from UGC in 2016. All the faculty members of College of Engineering Anantapur attended various workshops, FDPs, seminars organized by premier institutions. Every year, college will conduct national level student technical symposiums for students. College of Engineering Anantapur has IEEE student section. The faculty of college are involved in IE and ISTE. Faculty of Engineering published more than 540 research papers per year and on average for 10 years in various national and international journals and conferences, and secured more than 28 patents in national and international level for last 10 years. And produced more than 89 PhDs per and an average for 10 years. The Faculty of Engineering published more than 89 books in various disciplines. All the engineering departments have major research equipment useful to perform research activities. Regarding sports, every year college conducts annual sports meet. Our students secured various state level and national level recognitions in various sports activities like cricket, badminton, etc. Students' achievements. Students of College of Engineering Anantapur received 26 Pratibha Awards and an average per year given by AP state government, and placed in various MNCs in last few years and an average of 248 number in a year. And students secured good ranks in various competitive examinations like GATE, CAT, and an average of 75 per year in last few years, including AIR 1359, etc. The average pass percentage of students in the academic sees greater than 94%. Awards, many of our faculty received Best Teacher Awards from Government of AP. Our faculty received various awards from IE, ISTE, and other professional societies. And many more are there. Because of lapse of time, I'm concluding this. Thank you, one and all, for giving this opportunity. Thank you.
Never tell the people how to do things. Tell them what to do and they will surprise you with their ingenuity. Our Vice Chancellor, Professor G. Rangajanardhan, sir, exemplifies this quality which permeates through his immense contribution towards our university. Professor G. Rangajanardhan Garu also happens to be the alumni of this institute and is the man behind these celebrations.
Good morning to one and all. Very good morning to one and all. Yeah, that is the real Josh of JNTU, College of Engineering, Ananthapuram. I'm really indeed happy today that one of our alumni of this great institution is chief guest, that is none other than Dr. G. Satish Reddy Garu, 1980-84 batch ECE department of this great institution. And today's guest of honor, Professor K. Hemachandra Reddy Garu, Chairman, Andhra Pradesh State Council of Higher Education, who is also faculty of this institution. And the rector of this university, Registrar, the first woman principal of this college, all other dignitaries on the dais and off the dais. Once again, good morning to all of you. I'm also alumni of this institution, passed out in 87 from mechanical department. So today, we are celebrating the 75 years of glory of JNTA College of Engineering, Ananthapuram. It started on 13th with the opening of a special cover from the Department of Post, New Delhi. And then we have started a 4K run from Clock Tower to the campus on 15th of this month. We are really happy that initially we expected maybe around 300 to 400 faculty and students may join the rally. But it crossed more than 1,200. And all along the way, right from the clock tower to the campus, and it took nearly 1 hour. And the program was initiated on 16th, wherein Professor K. M. Chandra Reddy was the chief guest. In the inaugural speech, he reiterated that the importance of the alumni and the role of the alumni. And I would like to inform you that this institution started in 1946 and completed 75 years. We know that our alumni occupied various highest positions in their offices, right from chairman, CMDs, CEOs, and general managers of various public and private sectors and their own sectors. So this institution is growing fast with various state-of-the-art of infrastructure, both in terms of the buildings and the laboratories. But I request to remind you all that the way in which we are growing further, though it is at an increasing pace, but remember that the increase is at a decreasing rate. It is our duty to see that the increase in Our brand image should not be at the rate of decreasing. It should be also at the rate of increasing. I'm sure that all our engineering graduates and know about the, what is the meaning of increasing at the increasing rate and increasing at a decreasing rate. And the facilities that are available are to be renovated with the centers of excellences. And from the past 1 month, we are constantly interacting with various alumni branches. And a couple of days back, we have interacted through virtual mode, wherein more than 100 alumni across the globe, right from USA, UK, UAE, Singapore, and other countries, right from 1950s, 60s, 70s, 80s, and recent batch, alumni also joined in this virtual interaction. I'm really thrilled by their response and feedback and suggestions made for further growth of this institution. Here I would like to inform you that the infrastructure may be provided by the government or any philanthropist or any other. But recently, various countries are taking up ranking the institutions. In India also, we have a NAC, National Accreditation Association, NAC, wherein nearly 10 points are exclusively meant for the student and alumni role. They will take the response from the alumni, their happiness factor, their successful after completion of the four-year degree. So these also plays a vital role. It is immaterial how much we are donating. Need not be in terms of the financial matters, maybe in terms of the non-financial matters, but the number counts. That's why the Forbes also assesses the colleges based on GGI, Grateful Graduate Index. Based on these GGI, the Forbes grades the colleges with two matrices. One is the seven-year median gifts donated by the alumni. And the second matrix is the average number of donations by the alumni, irrespective of the amount. Let it be 1 rupee or 1 crore. The number also counts a lot. It all speaks the love and affection towards our alma mater, the respect and reward towards our alma mater. And the coming days are such that with mushrooming colleges coming up across the globe, apart from our state and India, we need to face and compete with the coming up institutions. I'm very sorry to say that recently the engineering college admissions were taken up in this year. I could found a top rankers joined in private universities in this state. What is the reason? It is a high time for all of us, right from the staff and the alumni, to rethink what is the reason for this. And we need to strengthen further both in terms of the research facilities, in terms of the innovation centers in this campus. I'm happy to announce that within a couple of months, we are going to inaugurate Innovation and Incubation Center, which is of 50,000 SFT. And I request all the alumni to use your good wishes and see that at least some of you join hands with the College of Engineering Anantapur to set up your own startup. We have recently completed a meeting also. We are coming up with rules and regulations for that. And the second point, This is only one example. In terms of number of publications, the India is standing at the top positions, maybe at the second or third. For example, in case of nanotechnology, India stood at third in terms of number of publications after the US and China. But the same are not converting into patents. When you think about in terms of patents, we are rock bottom. So the reason is there is no such ecosystem in the higher education systems in our country. We need to establish such ecosystems in the higher education institutions so that the young budding engineers, whatever their ideas are coming up, facilities must be provided in the campus so that their ideas will be made a reality. So this incubation and innovation center that is coming up in this campus will definitely be utilized by all our young budding engineers. And the second one is, it is not the question of going for the patenting. There must be facilities available in the institution. I'm happy to announce that MHRD has announced 1 crore rupee to establish IPR cell. We have processed all the modalities, and maybe in the month of January, we will open the IPR cell in the campus so that all our staff and students can utilize these facilities. This is at free of cost. So I request all the students in this campus, utilize these two facilities and see that you come up, you pass out in this institution, not only with a degree on one hand, at least along with a job, one patent also. So with these few words, I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to take the honor to invite the pride of our university and the guest of honor of today's meeting, Professor K. Hemachandra Reddy, sir, who is currently serving on the honorary designation of Chairman of APSCHE. Our beloved alumni is a great orator and an excellent teacher. His unique way of teaching incites inquisitiveness in the students to explore the subject to further depths. He is the personification of inspiring leadership, excellent administrative capabilities, tremendous energy, compassion towards students, and humanism.
Very good, good afternoon. At the outset, I extend a very warm welcome to all of you on this very auspicious day in the history of this college. JNTUA College of Engineering, Anantapur, formerly called as Government College of Engineering, Anantapur, has seen 75 years and it has traveled a very long way. And it has produced very distinguished alumni about whom the entire country is proud of. We have one such great alumni standing amidst us this afternoon as a chief guest. And he has a very important announcement to make to you, something which makes every one of us very, very happy. And not only Satish Reddy Garu, there are other distinguished alumni. I think the principal, the first woman principal of this college in all the 75 years, Professor Sujata, aptly introduced some of them. And I know it's not 1 year, 2 years to recollect all the distinguished alumni. 75 years, and in a history of, I mean, in a period of 75 years, this institution must have definitely produced great, great alumni. I know some of them, I heard about some of them, I have to know about remaining people, but then my life may not be sufficient to know about all of them. I'm not extending my greetings to all of them here because we are running out of the time. And this day belongs to the alumni because, you know, let them recollect their past experiences. Let them stand as motivation to the present students and roles. And when I look back, about this institution because I have a very long association with this institution. I just make a humble appeal to all my young friends to please be attentive, at least to the chief guest, because he himself is an inspiration. He can take you, his presence will take you to the next level. So, 75 years, when you holistically look at the entire institution profile, I could only say one thing. Last 75 years, it has taken many poor young aspirants into its fold, transformed them into, educated, intellectually expanded individuals, and rendered them to the society. Now, all those who graduated from this institution, this great institution, they have come out with many policies, they have invented many technologies, and they have made lives of thousands and thousands of people happy through their inventions and, interruptions. And this institution will stand further tall, in the history of this country. It will continue to serve this country, as a role model. I only have one appeal to make to all the alumni. Sir, you have come here. All of you are very happy about the developments this institution has witnessed in the previous times. I'm very glad every one of you are comparing the institution then and institution now. Let me tell you, sir, we have grown enormously in terms of volume, in terms of quantity. But definitely quality is a major concern. I was just traveling with Alur Samsivaradi Garu yesterday. He owns an engineering college, very decent engineering college in this very town. I asked him, now he has an intake of 720 students. I asked him, what is your built-up area? He said, 3 lakh square feet. I very quickly recollected, I have here on this 100 acres of sprawling campus, nearly 12 lakh square feet of building constructed already, for a mere intake of 360. His intake is 720. And I asked him further, how much you pay towards your salaries, spend towards your salaries per annum. He said 12 crores is what I spend towards salaries every year. And I inquired with my registrar, it is 65 crores every year we spend. See, the quantity wise, absolutely there is no issue with this institution. Only thing is, living up to the reputation of this institution, now you see the entire front rows, galaxy of people who made this institution so proud. It's all about quality, otherwise they would not have been here. But for the quality, they would not have been here. And they all came all the way, all the front rows, they are there sitting. They came all the way to inspire you with their quality. Now, quality shall be a mantra. Now, I said, national education policy, the previous policy was made in 1986. Now, in 2020, the government of India announced the new national education policy. After 36 years, we started very seriously discussing about educational reforms. We started very seriously talking about education 4.0. We started talking about the quality in higher education. We started talking about technology interventions. We started talking about vocationalization of education. Remember, after 36 years, now this 75th year shall be such a landmark year for this College of Engineering, Anantapur, that there shall be a very serious discussion in terms of revisiting the quality for this institution. Quality shall be the mantra for the next 75 years to come. And I only wish that all the stakeholders, students, faculty, parents, alumni, all of them will come together and work for it. I know alumni are always ready to extend their helping hand to this institution. Probably I have a feeling that we did not ask them the way we should have asked. probably I am getting a feeling that we did not convince them that their presence in the campus is very important. Probably we did not convince them to extend all kinds of possible help that they can extend to the institution. Now, yesterday, a couple of days before, you know, I had to address a small gathering. I quoted this incident, and because there are many students, I just wanted to give you this incident, though very short, once again for the benefit of the students. Let me tell you, some time back when I was a professor in the department, one boy from Ongole came. Now, it's a repetition. A few of you heard me, but then I thought it is very important for me to say it again. Now, boy was waiting for me as I opened my doors. I never knew this boy. And after I entered into the room, I inquired. He said, I came all the way from Ongole to take your help. I asked him, do you know me? He said, no, I don't know you. Then why did you come all the way? He said, I just thought meeting you will serve my purpose. I'll get my benefit. Then I asked him, what is that I should do? I'm just cutting it very short. He quickly pulled out five papers. He never knew me. He pulled out five papers from his folder, said, these are the profiles of five people whom you know very well. I asked him, how do you know that I know them very well? I have gone through your LinkedIn profile. I have gone through your Facebook profile. All these people are very close to you. And therefore, you know, if you can make one phone call to any one of them, they will provide me a job. I need my job. And I have all the capacities, credentials. You know, I was so impressed with the way he made his homework. You know, I called the first person who happened to be my classmate, told him, look, Shiv Kumar, I have a stranger here sitting in front of me who did such a wonderful homework. And he is asking for a job. And he was so impressed and said, don't hesitate even for a minute, ask him to come to me. I like the young boys of this kind, you know. You know, who could examine, who could explore, who could you know, identify their paths on their own. So immediately he was taken. I never knew this boy. He came all the way from Ongole just by searching my LinkedIn Facebook profiles. He plucked his job out of very thin air. You know, he walked away with a job. Now I just repeated this only to tell all my friends, the student friends. See, for the last 75 years, you have this many alumni, great alumni, who are all staying there. You know them. You have a reason to get connected to them. You can always go and approach them. They are all too willing. They don't even ask you a question, why did you come to me like I asked that boy from Ongole? They always would welcome you the moment you say, I am from JNTU College of Engineering, Ananthapur. They are always ready. Now, do you have it in you? Can you take it? Can you take it forward? Can you seek their help? Can you seek their, guidance? And, you know, sky is your limit for your growth. And all these people, 75 years, year on year, we started pumping high-quality engineers into the society. I only wish, you know, JNTU College of Engineering and JNTU University, now elevated to a university, this university will once again unshackle itself of all its old beliefs. Now, times are changing. You know, when I look at the first symbol, it is mechanical, electrical, and civil. And today, the mechanical, electrical, civil took a back seat. Electronics, electrical, and computer science took a front seat. Times are changing. Times are really changing. And we need to change. Education 4.0 is all about technology. Now you need to embrace technology. Go, now do away with all, you know, outdated beliefs. Unshackle yourself, faculty members particularly. Come together. Be very united. There are aspiring students coming to you. Provide them inspiring education. I don't have much to say. I am very eager to listen to the great man, Amit Sir. He has a very good news to share with us, all of us. Satish Reddy Garu, I'm just waiting for you. Thank you for this wonderful opportunity given to me.
Coming to the moment you all are waiting for, We now take this extreme privilege to call the chief guest of today, Dr. G. Satish Reddy Garu, who happens to be one of the most decorated alumni of JNTUA College of Engineering, Anandpur. Starting from the level of Scientist B in DRDO, he rose to the level of Chairman of DRDO within a span of 35 years. This fact speaks volumes about his commitment, his exceptional domain knowledge, and his extraordinary leadership qualities and enormous scientific contributions he has made to the field of defense development systems. He was instrumental in development of India's maiden successful test of anti-satellite missile mission Shakti, the world's longest range gun ATAGS, anti-radiation missile, smart airfield weapons, smart bombs, and missile-assisted torpedo release systems owe their success to Dr. Reddy's vision.
Recognizing his potential and in-depth knowledge about the defense research, the Government of India appointed him as a secretary to the Department of Defense R&D. JNTUA College of Engineering feels proud of his success and achievements as he is an alumnus of this wonderful institution. We take pride to be the students of the same college in which he has pursued his studies. We humbly request him to give his address as on this solemn occasion.
Namaskar. Good afternoon to all of you who are present here. Professor Hemchandra Reddy, who is holding the very important position in the Government of Andhra Pradesh for education. Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Ranga Janardhan, Sri Vijay Kumar, Rector, Dr. Sheshathar, Registrar, and most importantly, of the College of Anantapur Principal, Dr. Sujata. Our gurus who are present here, who have held eminent positions, Professor Venkatrama Reddy, Professor Krishnamacharyulu, Professor Sai Baba Reddy, our own contemporaries who are in very good positions and doing service for the nation, who are on the dais, Narayan Reddy, Ravinder Reddy, Harnath, and many others who are there on the dais, and off the dais, many people who are present, my batchmates, my seniors, my juniors, and lot of people who are present here. I think we can name many people who have come from various parts of the country also. Some people came from Karnataka, some people from Hyderabad, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh. Some people came from Kerala, some people came from even abroad, US. Many people who are present here. Very happy, extremely happy to see all of them. And most importantly, actually, we are all past. The present people who are present here, who are going to be the future, who are going to hold the positions like this, the present students of College of Engineering, JNTU, Anantapur. Very good morning, good afternoon, and namaskar to all of you. One thing is, I consider this as one of the greatest days of my life, again in this college, coming here and meeting all people with whom we have worked together and we have studied together, and meeting all of them here. I came here earlier a couple of times, but it was, I came alone, maybe two, three people were there. And then we had an event in the college, university, and then went back. But this time, all so many people coming here and meeting so many people together with whom we have studied together is a great occasion. What I want to say is, I don't know whether any other college in the entire country has this type of a power in the college and power in this particular land. The attachment what everyone who has studied in this college is great. They will never forget about this college and this campus till their last breath in their life. So much they attach the days what they have spent here, the everything, whatever you have done in the college. Whenever a small team of people from Anantapur, if they meet, they go back to the college days. They talk about the college days. In fact, I want to say, till I think my batch came into this college, that is in 1980, there were no ladies, women. There was, I think, only one woman used to be there for the entire 4 years. First time, six girls joined in our batch. Why I'm telling is, when we meet, most of us are gentlemen, men who are meeting and talking about the college days. So the women, actually the wives, leave. Victoria will excuse me for that, but the wives become jealous of this college. What is this college? Why you talk so much? Why you talk about the smats? Why you talk about the food, what you all ate there and so many things. In fact, when I was coming here first time to this college, my wife said, I want to see that what is this college you people keep on talking. So she came along with me, went along with me to all the hostels, campus, mess, everything. So much. Actually, people are so much attached and they love this place. A lot of, as I said, power is there. Still, I was also talking to morning Dr. Sujata about the old campus days. How was the old campus? Now you don't see, but old campus particularly is the most important place for us in the college days that time. I also want to say that when I talk about the power of this campus and this college and this land here, and today was a very important and critical day for us in DRDO. We had a very important test what was happening today. I couldn't go there and I came here. Very important mission. And I want to tell you, when we went for the pylon inauguration, when the puja started, just when the puja started, the Agni Prime, which is a very important missile, just took off. As he started the puja, it took off. And next 15 minutes, as the puja, as the inauguration was going on, the missile was perfectly going like a textbook launch and landed there. And till that time, I was naturally will be under tension, under stress, what is happening, what are activities going on, continuously looking into the messages and things like that. But then, the power of the college is such that the puja time started, it took off and it went on. And it's a great success for the nation, which actually, as soon as the mission is over, Honorable Defense Minister Sri Rajnath Singh spoke to me and congratulated. Then National Security Advisor Sri Ajit Doval ji congratulated and asked me to convey my wishes to all the scientists. So that is the power. Actually, I don't know, when I came first time after leaving this college, I came after a long time. When that time also I said, when you looked at every stone here, every tree here, every leaf here, you felt that it is part and parcel of your life and part and parcel of the body. That is the type of attachment the people who here they have developed. And it has produced so many eminent people. So many eminent people. Actually, Dr. Sujata was mentioning all those names. I don't want to get into. There are many eminent people who are present here, part of them, and that names also she has already narrated, so I don't want to say. But today, when we look at the important people who are occupying the positions in Delhi, I'll just tell them. In the Government of India, of the secretaries who are there in the Delhi, two of the secretaries are from this college. Two of the secretaries. One is Sri A. Giridhar, who was again 1980 to 1984 batch, my batchmate, and he is the secretary road transport and holds an important position, Secretary of Road Transport, and who is valued as one of the very important secretaries, and who is known for his eminence. And many times in the COVID, he has been given an in charge of the whole COVID oxygen management and everything, that position he was given. And when there was one more department became vacant, he is the one who was given the additional charge of that, and who is actually making this country, the roads are laid kilometers and kilometers per day. Now they are changing it to kilometers to per hour. That is the type of roads what they are trying to make. He is one who is holding important position. And of course, the second secretary is me, holding the position of Secretary Defense R&D there. Then, in DRDO, we have very important positions after the secretary, the director generals. Director generals, we have about 9 director generals who look after various things, aeronautics or missiles and many things. So 2 of the director generals who are there right now with me in DRDO are from JNTU Ananthapur. He is one, Mr. G. N. Rao, G. Narasimha Rao, 1981-85 batch, holding the position of Director General for Industry, Armed Forces, and International Affairs of the whole Defense R&D. Looks after, he interacts with the services and all that, what they want, what to do, how to test, how to induct, and then developing the industries and working with the various foreign countries, he is the in charge. And another director general is Shri Varaprasad. He is from, again, 1981 to 85 batch. It so happened that the 2 secretaries belong to 80-84, and the 2 director generals become 81 to 85 batch. So there are 4 people right now who are in very important positions in Delhi from this college. That is the uniqueness. I don't know. I don't think maybe IITs, couple of people may be there, IAS officers who are present there from various IITs. But as a college, I don't think 4 important positions are held by one college people, and that belongs to Ananthapur. So when we look at this college is so important and so significant college, the way it has started from Guindy and came here, and that's how we are celebrating 1946 to 2021, 75 years. College is known for its eminence. College is known for its professors. College is known for producing eminent people with so much of a knowledge from particularly the beginning days was civil department and mechanical department, and then electrical department, then electronics department, then of course later computer science and all that added. So they were so strong people, and the professors, we all know when we joined who all the professors were there. They were all known in the country for their eminence, and that's how the college name and college strength, and that's how the people have been produced. And I'm sure that same parampara will be continuing here and producing eminent people and having eminence in the academic institute and university here. Friends, like to say that today's scenarios are changing. Lots of things are happening. Universities are actually improving their standards day by day. When you look at various universities or institutes in the country, if you look about 10 years back, there was no single institute or university in the world's first 500 rankings. But today, there are many things, many institutes which have come in the first 500. There are many IITs, many institutes which have come in the first 500 of the world rankings. So there are lots of improvements happening. Our own institutes are going to the world standards, and day by day we are improving. And it is Honorable Prime Minister's wish and ambition that we should have many institutes in the first 100 from this nation. We should have many institutes in the first 100. So there are people are striving for it. There are many private institutes have come who are also doing well. So it is now every university's, the management, or the students, or the faculties endeavor that the university's rankings, our university's eminence, our university's strength should be day by day enhanced with various thought processes. That is the most important thing. Not only from the, as I said, vice chancellor or principal or the professors, even from the students, we all have to work for that and say that we should make this university or this campus an eminent campus. See, if we are not improving day by day, as the camp, many institutes are coming up in the rankings, so naturally our ranks will go down. So all of us who are sitting here, who are thinking proud of this institute, will not be thinking so in later. And then people also who join in this institute will not be very good students. So it is all our other duty. Now I want to say that it is the duty of the alumnus of this institute also to do so. We all have to work together to make this institute an eminent institute. So I request all of us who are present here, along with the university administration, our college administration, and all of us, let us think how we can actually make this institute an eminent institute. What we can contribute and how we can contribute, what we can do. This same thing when I was talking to Giridhar one day, he said, let us do something, Satish. From my part, from the Department of Road Transport, I'll create a chair in that institute, which from the Department of Road Transport, I'll create a chair. Let the proposal come from the institute and we'll create a chair, was the immediate reaction from him. And I'm sure that the vice chancellor has taken the steps and we can go ahead. From my side, I will also say that, firstly, we have this year introduced M.Tech courses in defense technologies. And so, if the university is willing, let us start the M.Tech course in defense technologies, and I will provide the faculty for that defense technologies completely. And we will also ensure all those M.Tech students who are actually going to study here in defense technologies, I'll ensure that all of them will get their second year internship or project work they will do in DRDO laboratories, each one of them. And also I request the professors who are present here, who can actually come out with some problem solutions or actually research topics which they want to take up, which will be useful directly or indirectly for defense. We are ready to provide all the projects. We are ready to fund the university with those projects, which actually enables your laboratories will be strengthened, your faculty will have a lot of research associates, and a lot of funding will be coming. We are ready to fund. I want to tell you, today, DRDO works with about 300 academic institutes in the country, and with about 10 centers of excellence in various academic institutes, including IIT Chennai, IIT Mumbai, IIT Delhi, Jadavpur University, Jammu University, Mizoram University, Bharatiyar University, Hyderabad Central University, Gujarat University. These are all the universities where we have centers of excellence. And with 300 academic institutes, the budget for the academic institutes from DRDO is 1,000 crores. 1,000 crores is what being done. So if the university, JNTU Anantapur, comes forward, we are ready to give projects and we are ready to fund you. This is another thing what I like to tell you. There is also one more scheme we have recently introduced to actually support or to encourage young graduates, and also even if, I will tell you about it later, young graduates who just pass from the institute, and mostly generally they will not be knowing what they should do. Some people will think that they will go for M.Tech program or PhD program or some academics. Some people will try to look for a job, or some people will be thinking, I want to start an industry or a startup, but he doesn't know what to do, what type of a topic. So what we are saying is, if any student who just comes out of the university or institute, if he wants to take up a problem and he wants to do research in that and come out with a solution or a prototype for that, we fund that student through an incubation center if the university has got. I heard that there is an incubation center here in JNTU Anantapur. Each one, we fund up to 10 crore rupees, each student. And some of the problems what we feel you can address, those have been put in DRDO website. You can go through it. And if you apply for that problem, or you think that this is the problem, what actually I can work on this and provide a solution to armed forces in the country or security agencies in the country. It can be anything also. It can be cyber security problem. It can be artificial intelligence problem, or it can be quantum technology related problem, or anything also. We will fund each case up to 10 crore rupees. This is one thing which actually university can avail, properly looking at this and trying to encourage the people, students and professors jointly together. This is the basic aim is the student doesn't have to invest anything into it, and we are actually making the investment, and he comes out with a solution, and that paves the way for him to establish the industry and then get into the production mode of it. Similarly, anybody who has come out of this institute and they have established their own MSME, the same feature of this 10 crore rupees funding for a defense-related problem, if you want to work on developing a product, we can fund up to 10 crore rupees. This is also one more important thing which is there. Also, for the mostly for the students, even though it is open for everyone, we have actually put a contest every day, every year, called Dare to Dream. Actually, our guru, the former president of this country, Dr. ABJ Abdul Kalam, who has been always continuously working with the children, he has been always with the students, particularly after he has come out of as a chairman or secretary DD R&D, and then he was continuously with the children. He was going to every school, every college, and he was trying to actually motivate them, inspire them to become great nations. Why? You all know that you are the ones who are the future of this country. If I can inspire them, if I can motivate them, this country will become a great nation. So he used to tell them, dream, dream, dream. That you dream that you are going to become a great engineer, you are going to be a great doctor, you are going to become a great lawyer, you are going to become a great chartered accountant, or you are going to become a great politician, or you are going to become a great cine actor or director or whatever it is, or you are going to create great things in the nation. So you dream like that, and then to make the dream a reality, you will be continuously working without sleeping after that. So once you dream, you don't sleep. So you used to say dream, dream, dream. Taking that as the inspiration of it, we have put this contest called Dare to Dream. Every year we put in about six verticals, six areas. Anybody can put a good idea in that, and the contest is all India evaluated, and the number of scrutiny will go on. Last year about 30,000 applications came, and scrutiny is very difficult, but then number of people are given awards and rewards, good amount. 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 25 lakhs, 30 lakhs, like that, is given to each successful vendor, successful student. And then, if that problem where he has come out with the idea is very good, he is brought into this 10 crore rupees scheme, and he is funded 10 crore rupees to make this idea a reality. So, you all can utilize this. It is now, contest is again open now. So, these are all the various mechanisms which are available in the government of India. We should actually know. There are many things. There is something, a scheme called IDEX. This is also a scheme where students and various people can participate and then get a lot of funding from that. So similarly, in science and technology, DST, CSIR, many schemes are there wherein the students slash professors slash the institutes can participate and try to get many fundings and many schemes and things like that and all that. It is only that somebody should take this responsibility, keep tapping all these things, and take help from people like us to utilize these opportunities and get that and make the university a best university. Lots of things are happening. Why I'm saying is, I have one university with the DRDO called Defense Institute of Advanced Technologies. And recently, actually, about 10 foreign universities, including Cranfield and all that, they came with an MOU for this and trying to work there. We have a students exchange program, PhD exchange program, many things also. And in fact, when I say PhD, the Ministry of Higher Education has sanctioned 500 PhD students to work in DRDO laboratories. This is another opportunity which we can, next 5-6 years, we want to produce 500 PhD theses in defense-related subjects, and the students work in defense laboratories. There will be a professor who is guide, and there is a scientist who will be guiding. And this is also one more scheme. Like, there's a lot of schemes we are coming out. In fact, you suggested some more schemes. We'll try to come out with some more suggestions. In fact, there are, you see, the Honorable Prime Minister, he is not satisfied with any incremental improvement or incremental improvement. He wants to see a quantum jump. Last year, we conducted one program called Vaibhav. The Vaibhav is Vaishvik Bharatiya Vignan Sammelan. Vaishvik Bharati Vignan Sammelan. We collected 8,000 eminent professors and scientists of Indian origin who are working in various eminent institutes. Not everyone. I'm again using the word 8,000 eminent professors and scientists, and then collected all of them. And then there have been parallelly here also in the Indian side, academic institutes and professors we have gathered. And then we have taken up 80 subjects. And these people from that side and this side, totally they discussed for about 24 days on all these 80 topics. 732 hours they discussed in each subject, what should we do, how we should go ahead. And then they came out with suggestions what should be done, how these professors outside and the professors here, these institutes and professors can work together and make this country an eminent country in each of the subject. And we have produced 100 documents and we have submitted to the Prime Minister's office. A lot of things are going to happen in that Vaibhav program, and the program will be taken. The idea is that we should, utilizing all these eminent people working abroad, working or teaching abroad, and our own people work together and make our academic institutes and our students, our professors also, everywhere eminent, and have these, know the best cultures and make things come out of these academic institutes the best. What I am saying is, academic institutes are the primary source of eminence. The core research or generating a good student is from academic institute. See, today, friends, I want to say, I think just take 5 more minutes. The country is technologically growing very fast. We are actually no less than the few advanced nations in the world. I will quote examples. Take ISRO, the space. We have PSLV programs continuously going on, one after other. I think last few years, we had a row of continuously, without one missing, more than 50 PSLVs have been successful. More than 50 PSLVs. And the same PSLV, we have gone for Chandrayaan, we have gone for Mars mission, and we have our own GSLV missions and our own cryogenic engines. We developed our own cryogenic engines, and soon we'll have Gaganyaan, where a man is going to be put into the space also. So we are no less than any of the first 5-6 nations. Look at atomic energy, Department of Atomic Energy. Again, same thing. They have done wonders. Wherever it is, you have nuclear plants, nuclear power is generated, nuclear bombs have been generated, anything, whatever you talk in the world, have been generated here. We are no less than that. I don't want to get into more details into that particular department. Look at defense technologies. I want to tell you, the recent success what has been done in 2019, the anti-satellite mission Shakti, which Honorable Prime Minister has told us, I want you to do it in 2 years. He told us in 2016 September, do it in 2 years. 2 years doing such a mission is near to impossible. But this country has, DRDO has taken it as a challenge. And 2019, we went ahead and have hit a satellite in the low Earth orbit and became the fourth nation in the world who have done such an anti-satellite mission, America, Russia, and China. And today you look at the various missiles, the Agni, Prithvi, whatever I am saying, we are the sixth nation in the world who have such capabilities, one of the six nations. And you know the city next to you here, Bangalore, is the aircrafts, where LCA aircrafts we are producing, light combat aircrafts. We are one of the six nations in the world who have produced their own combat aircraft. One of the six nations we are produced, and Indian Air Force has given 123 numbers orders, which is the single largest ever order. Similarly, we have produced Arjun tank. That is again one of the six nations in the world. We have produced submarines. We are one of the five nations in the world. We have actually ballistic missile defense. If an enemy's ballistic missile is coming, you intercept in the midway and kill it in the space itself. We are one of the four nations again there. And recently, we have made a gun in the country, which you must have heard from none other than Honorable Prime Minister, which is a 155mm artillery gun. This is the world's longest range gun in the world today, artillery gun. So see, there are many things happening. The things are happening very fast. Lots of new technologies are coming. But then, this country has to become prosperous. If the country has to become prosperous, it is the technology which makes this country prosperous. If the technology we have to produce, we have to produce advanced technologies, more and more on futuristic technologies. So the core technology, the base for that comes from the academic institutes, the core research, the basic research should happen here. The institutes like us, ISRO, DRDO, Atomic Energy, CSIR and all that, they do applied research to translational research, and industry takes it up and produces inequality. This is the whole chain. So the base is from the academic institutes. If the academic institutes are not flourishing here, if the academic institutes are not becoming strong, then the nation producing such things will not work. How the nation will become prosperous? Our products have to go entire world. Every country, they should see our products. If we are able to sell that, if you want to sell that, your product has to be most advanced technology, innovative technology, the price has to be lower, cheaper, and then the quality has to be good. If we have to meet these three, then the fundamental element is the technology. That is where we are looking for academic institutes and could come up. So it is all our duty to see that if the nation has to become prosperous. When Honorable Prime Minister, 5 years back, he gave a call for Make in India. Now, the slogan is not Make in India. The slogan is Make for the World. Slogan is Make for the World. So we need to make the products here which we have to sell the world, and all of us have to work together. So it is our duty to see that the academic institutes are flourishing. And so we, being from this college, this institute, all of us, let us try to make this institute flourish. And they're all eminent people. They're all the CMDs. There are general managers. There are chief engineers. And many other positions people are there. Let us see, all of us, what we can do this institute. In fact, I request the vice chancellor to take all of our names and mails and everything. You can communicate with each and everyone and see that what way we can connect to you. It is not that actually somebody has to donate money. It is not, that is the last. We have to see what way we can support this institute, what mechanisms we can create, and see that the university flourishes. So you may conduct with various groups and VC also, people, difficult for the people these days to travel, and then take ideas and see how we can motivate. And that is the way actually this happiness for coming here will be really put into practice and make this university a great university, make these people are also going to come out as great people serving this nation, making the nation great. Thank you very much for offering me and calling me here, giving me this opportunity.
Sir, just a minute. Just a minute. Namaskar. We are proud of you. We are proud of our college and we are proud of our nation. Please give a standing ovation for the Agni success today. Please.
Thank you.
NSS clap goes to NSS, NSS, NSS.
Thank you very much, sir, for your inspiring and motivating words to the young minds. Thank you very much, sir.
We have a couple of announcements to make on this great occasion. We request JNTU College of Engineering, Anantapur, APSP, DCL alumni batch to come on to the dais for presenting 25 rupees 25 lakh check to the college through the honorable chief guest of today's function. Let us welcome them with a big round of applause, please. Sorry, 27 lakh rupee check.
To inform you that JNTU CEA, SPDCL Alumni Association, sponsoring SPDCL, sir. APSPDCL, JNTU College of Engineering, Anantapur branch. Yes, sir. Team led by our Harnath Garu, CMD. I'm very happy that all the great alumni of this institution formed a separate group under APSPDCL. Thank you very much.
Thank you, JNTU CEA, APSPDCL alumni batch. Thank you very much for your support.
We request our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Rangajanardhan sir, to make an announcement regarding establishment of innovative labs in the campus through 7983 alumni badge.
I'm happy to inform that we are pleased to inform you that the institution has entered MOU with the 7983 badge alumni for establishing Innovation Makers Lab facility called InnoLab 83. At JNTU premises.
Request 7983 batch to come on to the ICE.
With a total project outlay of 50 lakhs to serve the alma mater by catering to the needs of students' community in enhancing employability and entrepreneurial skill development.
Request the Honorable Vice Chancellor and the Chief Coordinator of 7983 batch to sign the MOUs and exchange the MOUs. Thank you.
We thank all the alumni of 7983 batch for supporting us in establishing Innovation Makers Lab.
We thank 7983 alumni batch for their magnanimous gesture towards this institution. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. We request Sambhajiva Reddy Garu, he has an announcement to make. We request him to make the announcement. Sambhajiva Reddy Garu, alumni of this institution, is contributing 9.2 lakhs for constructing a room in the Platinum Jubilee Hostel. Thank you so much for your contribution.
Under this auspicious occasion of 75 years, we have planned for construction of 100 rooms Platinum Jubilee Hostel. And Sambhajiva Reddy Garu is donating for one room. Sambhajiva Reddy and his wife Padmavati, she is the MLA of Singanmala. So both are alumni of this particular institute, and they passed mechanical batch 98. So now they are donating for the construction of one room costing 9.2 lakhs. Thank you, Ananal.
So this is only few. There are several announcements are there already in the pipeline. I'm getting all the feedback from them. But in a couple of days, they are in finalizing their proposals. So soon we will put all these details in our web portal. Thank you very much.
Now I request the university officials and the college officials to felicitate our chief guest. Satish Reddy Garu.
అభివృద్ధి చెందింది. ఒకసారి చెప్తాను వినండి, ఒకసారి అందరూ కళ్ళు మూసుకోండి. ఓ మెయిన్ బిల్డింగు, సివిల్ డిపార్ట్మెంటు, ఎలక్ట్రికలు, వర్క్షాపు ఉన్నాయని భావించండి. మిగతా బిల్డింగ్స్ ఏమీ లేవు, ఒక అంత బ్యారన్ ల్యాండ్ అన్నమాట. ఇక్కడ ఉండే అందరిలోనూ ఫస్ట్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్ విజిట్ చేసింది నేనే 1952లో. అట్ ఏజ్ ఆఫ్ 9 యాజ్ అన్ ఎక్స్కర్షన్, అప్పుడు ఎక్స్కర్షన్ స్పాట్ అనమాట. ఇది చిన్న ట్యాంకు, ఆయన చోట కండమేరు. మేమంతా 9 ఏళ్ళప్పుడు వచ్చామో చూసామన్నమాట. అది కాలేజీ 75 ఏళ్ళలో ఎంత డెవలప్ అయిందో ఒకసారి చూడండి. రెండోది విషయం చెప్తాను, అంటే సారీ 1959 నేను ఆర్ట్స్ కాలేజ్లో పీయూసీ చదువుతున్నాను. అప్పుడు ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్ అనంతపురము, ఆర్ట్స్ కాలేజ్ అనంతపురము హాకీ క్రికెట్లో ఫస్ట్, ఇంటర్ కాలేజ్ కాంపిటీషన్ జరుగుతున్నాయి. ఆర్ట్స్ కాలేజీ, ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజీ రెండు కూడా ఫైనల్స్కి వచ్చాయి. తిరుపతిలో ఆడారు, డ్రా. భద్రపల్లి ఆడారు, డ్రా. అనంతరం ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజీ గౌడ్స్లో హాకీలో ఆడారనమాట. అప్పుడు నేను ఆర్ట్స్ కాలేజ్ చూసేదానికి వచ్చిన, రెండు సార్లు కూడా డ్రానే. మళ్ళా టాస్ వేశారు, టాస్ వేస్తే అనంతరం ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్ గెలిచింది. నేను అనంతరం ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్ చదవలేదు, కానీ అనంతరం ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్లో 38 ఏళ్ళు కంటిన్యూస్గా చదివేదానికి భగవంతుడు నాకు ఆశీర్వాదం చేశాడు, మిమ్మల్ని అందరినీ చూసేదానికి చేశాడు. రెండు మాటలు మాట్లాడతాను. మనకు భూమాత, గోమాత, తలనిచ్చిన జన్మనిచ్చిన మాత అనగా విద్యనిచ్చుని సరస్వతి మాత, ఈ నలుగురు మాతలను ఎవరు మర్చిపోద్దండి. నేను చెప్పేదంటే ఇప్పుడు చదివే విద్యార్థులకు ముందు ముందు కూడా ఈ కాలేజీని మీరు గుర్తుపెట్టుకోండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ ది ఆపర్చునిటీ. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
all the proud teachers are very happy to felicitate one of the greatest student or chief guest. Please, with a great applause, everybody.
I request all the dignitaries to felicitate our guest of honor, Professor K. Hemachandra Reddy. We request the dignitaries to felicitate Balaveera Reddy Garu.
We request to felicitate Harnath Rao sir,
G.R. Reddy Garu, Narayan Reddy Garu, Jonnalagadda Padmavati Garu, A. Sambasiva Reddy Garu.
After the felicitation, there will be a photo session in front of the auditorium. After this function, there will be a photo session in front of the auditorium.
I request all the alumni and all the students to join for a group photograph. After the function, please. Outside the auditorium.
We request Professor V.K. Paul, Commandant, Indian Coastal Guard, to express a vote of thanks.
Honorable dignitaries on the dais, distinguished guests and alumni, faculty, non-teaching staff, students, press and electronic media, ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed a great honor and privilege for me to propose vote of thanks for this august gathering. Strong, fabulous and dedicated. On behalf of JNTU, CEM, staff, students, and also on behalf of our university administration, our deep sense of appreciation to Dr. G. Satish Reddy, Secretary, Department of Defense Research and Development, and Chairman DRDO for sparing his precious time and accepting to be the chief guest for this glorious 75-day celebration. It reflects his love and affection towards us, his alma mater. Sir, you have inspired us with your words of wisdom, and we will continue to look towards you for guidance and further inspiration. Sir, your rich presence and blessings has given strength and conviction in taking this institution to further heights. Thank you, sir. We are honored to have you here with us today. Further, we are grateful to the great orator, a teacher par excellence, our very humble Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu, Chairman APSCHE, for his insights on quality as mantra to establish greater glory by every passing batch. Thank you very much, sir, for your presence. I like to express my sincere thanks to the great teacher and administrator who was visionary behind transformation of JNTU and in spite of occupying the highest administrative post, who always feels his belonging to this college, Professor Y. Venkatram Reddy Garu. Thank you very much, sir, for your active participation in this celebration, for gracing this occasion. I also wish to express my gratitude to great alumni who has his alma mater proud by his achievements, who was the Vice Chancellor of the Vishwesvaraya Technology University, Karnataka, and an authority of national education policy, Professor Balavira Reddy Garu. Thank you, sir, for gracing this occasion and your enthusiastic participation in these celebrations. I'm also very grateful to another great alumnus who made a mark as a principal of this alma mater, Professor Sai Baba Reddy Garu, has made this function more graceful by his presence. Thank you very much, sir. Our gratitude to our beloved Vice Chancellor, Professor G. Rangajanathan, sir, for his inspiring and guiding all along the way in conduct of this 75-year celebration. Thank you once again. Heartfelt thanks to all the sponsors who have contributed generously for conducting this event successfully. Our thanks to the teaching staff. Our thanks to the teaching and non-teaching staff of the college as well as university and the students who were in various committees and who worked hard to make this event a grand success. I extend our heartfelt thanks to the press and media for their excellent support and cooperation in giving wide publicity to this event. Thank you, one and all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. We request everyone to please stand in the honor of national anthem. Thank you. Request to clear the way for the police band, please.
After the national anthem, the band, after playing the national anthem, will pass through this aisle. Please clear the place. The passage has to be kept clear so that band can pass after the national anthem is over. Thank you very much. Band.
I request all the alumni to have lunch in the ground floor, dining hall, please. I request all the teaching staff, non-teaching staff and alumni to have their lunch in the ground floor, please. Dining hall. Here only, below this hall, we have a dining hall. Please have your lunch and we'll meet at... Yeah, we'll meet at 2:30, please. I request all of you to have our lunch and we'll meet at 2:30, please. I once again request all the alumni, teaching staff, and non-teaching staff to have your lunch in the dining hall of this auditorium and we'll meet again at 2:30. The meeting will continue, please. Because there are a lot number of alumni are there, so we want to hear their voices. I request all the alumni to have their lunch and again we'll meet at 2:30, please.
I request the band to take the position and then continue, route them to all for the dining hall, please. Yeah, in the ground floor. Band, can you take the position? Go to the second door, all of you. Second door, please. Please start, sir. Yeah. Yes, sir. Please to any route, sir. No problem. Start, sir. I request the band to take move. All the members assemble before the auditorium. There will be group session, photo, and then followed by lunch. Please take the straight doors. Band, please start. Band, please move forward. I request everyone to join for the photo session in front of the auditorium. Please. So the lunch is provided in the downstairs of auditorium in the same building. And the afternoon session sharply starts at 2:30. I request all to assemble. Thank you.